Like things with a sad ending, because otherwise you cry
yourself to sleep. What is the more serious genre?
I like comedy. Okay.
What about you?
I'm more of a dance movie kind of thing, because obviously I'm interested in dance, so I like watching loads of dance.
So, what do you expect to see in an opening sequence for a film?
Introducing the characters, their personalities, where they are at that point in their life that we're going to be watching.
Right, this is our idea. It's a crime drama. The synopsis is there's a young, medium young girl who enters a relationship with an older man who's 25 years old. At first, their relationship is perfect, but the man turns out to be abusive and mistreats her constantly. Feeling alone and believing she has no hope or any other option, she then makes a horrible decision to end his life before he ends hers. What we want to achieve, a complex psychological crime drama that establishes and unravels as the plot advances the issues of domestic violence and the mentality of those that are victims. They're going to identify the loneliness and humiliation that erupts from it. So, our main black female character, or our main black female character, whether or not there is murder is not revealed in the opening sequence. Instead, it erupts to an active audience to use the bits of information we, as a group, give them to deconstruct. So basically, we don't actually show what is happening, it's up to you to work it out. Whether or not there has been a murder, and who the murderer is left to the audience to guess, our plot is so complex, this is a typical red mention in crime drama, that even the murderer is not overtly shown, so assumptions have to be made by the audience. So this is our main character. Her name's Sarah. She's a black 18-year-old girl. We see her in two states, one in a flashback where she's a young girl in love, and another in a broken wreck crying on the floor in a very little mental state intact. The man's name is James. She's in a relationship with. He's 25 years old. We never actually see what he looks like, so he's always the same small head or his back. We see him in two states again. One is a man of a happy, healthy relationship, and another with an abusive, dominating partner. So do you think that anything will be improved on? I'll just tell you.
No.
No improvements.
I'm sure there are more characters in that film.
Oh yeah, but these are just the characters we've seen in that opening sequence, so like the first 2 minutes or so. So what actually happens in the opening sequence? This is the voiceover that Sarah, the main character, is saying. So yeah, I'm gonna read that. Basically, it's got to do with using a fairy tale as an example of what you would expect from a relationship, but what it actually turned out like. It's very different. The query that you had would be answered throughout the rest of the film. So, throughout, after the opening sequence, we'll show the woman how she doesn't actually think he's rubbish, how she might work quite hard, and he has something wrong with him. But it is immediately obvious to the audience. This is an example of another film that uses a female main character and a voiceover at the end. So this like kind of sets the tone.
Two things you might have to highlight for yourself. They have to highlight. just come back from being in the deep.
Yeah, so that changed your opinions on the open door. Now that you've seen one,
boring because it takes up time when the actual plot would be playing out. So the voiceover could like help iron out the final details and then you go on to the plot.
Yeah, that's intended. Okay, this is the screenplay. This isn't actually the finished version, but this is close enough to what it would be like. So it begins with a long shot of a dark room with her sitting in the corner. See a knife in her hand, and the camera pans to her face. It goes to a flashback of Sarah and James. We now have them in a coffee shop, like laughing and chatting, having a good time. It cuts back to her in the room, and throughout this is where the voiceover begins. We see another flashback of a point of view shot, so like the camera's looking, seeing what she's seeing, of her on the floor looking up at James. We cut back to her in the room. Then we get like the flashback to kind of cut between each other. So we see them, and it's like a bright, summery, happy time to have a coffee shop. And from the when the relationship is good, then it cuts to the bad times. And in one of these flashbacks, it hits her, and the camera rolls over. And then the screen goes to black, and that's when the title shows. So we're showing the good times from their relationship and the bad. Do we have the other screenplay on that? Oh no, we don't, it's not on the system. Right, so don't worry about that. And obviously domestic violence is represented through our group. So how do you think this issue could be represented sensitively or not? Because obviously we don't want to offend anyone who might be going through this. Do you have any ideas of how we could show it in a sensitive way?
I think, in the way the female character is portrayed, you don't want to make her seem too oblivious, because not all victims of domestic violence are. I think it's just being delicate with the fact that some people do stay in violence. Relationships because they feel like they can change them or it could get better. But yeah, it's showing the different emotions that they go through sensitively, not like massively emphasizing them. Because it's not about that, it's just about why they choose to stay and like they find this.